40 years ago, these four-wheel drive Dodge trucks helped America do a really tough job. This year, the Dodge four-wheel drive Power Wagons will do more tough jobs than ever with standard full-time four-wheel drive that costs extra on Ford and Chevy. And the W150 has the lowest price of any short-wheelbase four-wheel drive pickup built in America. Dodge Power Wagons, doing America's toughest jobs for more than 40 years.
Dodge is into trucking like America's into jeans.
Hey, that's my Dodge.
Hey everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. We are driving today a 1978 Dodge Power Wagon. This truck is a special edition. It is a factory Sno-Commander package. It's actually a really rare truck. We're actually going to take it for a drive. Come with us. What's special about this truck, it's a factory full-time four-wheel drive. The truck is always in four-wheel drive. The design of it was you never get stuck. So these trucks were designed for like highway departments, DPWs, the state, farmers, construction, anything that you were off the main road. These trucks also came factory with a 8-foot Myers plow. This truck also had built-in factory controls in the dash. You could have came option with a rear tailgate sander. So one of the cool features about this truck, it has the factory paint still on it. So this truck's all original, minus the work that we've done to it. Came stock with a citrus green poly high-vis paint. So this truck was designed for plowing, so they wanted it to be something that stood out and was really bright. It also came stock with reflective decals, and it's still got the matching green wheels on it with mud and snow tires on it like it would have had factory. This truck came stock with a 360 V8 with automatic transmission. This truck's only got just over 48,000 miles on it, so it's very low. Dana front axle, Chrysler rear axle, and it's all-time four-wheel drive, so it's kind of neat. It drives down the road pretty good. It's not like it's gonna win speed records by any means, but you know, kind of cool. Like you pull into a muddy field, you don't have to put it in four-wheel drive because it's already in four-wheel drive. They also advertise that these trucks came, you know, factory disc brakes as well, for better stopping power. You know, back in the 70s, cars were just catching on to having disc brakes. That wasn't a common necessity. Everybody was still running drum brakes up until the 70s and 80s. This truck also came stock with auxiliary lighting on it, so it had all the plow lights, all the caution lights. It also came stock with a high output alternator so it could run all the plow accessories. From the story behind this truck is it was purchased new up in upstate New York. It was purchased by a church and it plowed its parking lot. It's probably what saved this truck. These trucks were just beat to snot. All the highway departments, all the construction places used them, plowed with them, and they just all rotted out. So you don't see any of them anymore. We did not do a full restoration on this truck. What we did was we did some detail work. We did some rust preventiveness on the underside of the truck. So we needle scaled everything down, wire wheeled everything, and fluid filmed the whole chassis. We redid all the brake lines, all the fuel lines. We redid the front and rear axles. The front axle was pretty spent. So the whole front axle is all brand new, all new bearings. We serviced the engine. Did some gaskets on it, a thermostat gasket, tune up. And we also sent the radiator out and had that recored. The aftermarket radiators, in my opinion, aren't that great. So we had a factory radiator record. Working on some wheels and tires for it. It's got the factory set up on it right now with some old school mud and snow tires on it. It's not a full restoration, but it's something unique. It's something different. Hopefully down the road we're going to be able to restore this with the customer, but at the moment he just wants to be able to enjoy it. The truck is now going to be living on Martha's Vineyard. Still got the factory plow set up. We do not have the plow here, so the customer has that. Another thing that we did on this truck was we replaced the windshield and the weather stripping on that. So we've done a lot of mechanical maintenance on this truck to keep it up and running. That's a lot of things that we do here at the shop is, you know, We just don't do full restorations. So if you have something wicked special and, you know, we got to do service work on it, that's not a problem. I would think this truck is pretty rare. I would think it's maybe this 500 of these trucks left in the country. Maybe. Every time you go somewhere with it, everybody's got a cool story to talk about with it. We took it up to one of the local farms and one of the local DPWs and did a photo shoot there just to kind of give it its, you know, its natural habitat. As you can see on it, it's not perfect, but it's a really nice driver. The customer's going to be able to use it, tow his trailer, use it as a truck still, but have something unique that nobody else has. One of the cool things about this truck is it's when you open up the door, it smells like a nostalgic 80s Dodge truck. Reminds me of my grandfather's Dodge truck he had back in the 80s. He had a two-wheel drive Dodge D150, I believe it was called, and it was the Prospector edition, so it was bright gold and yellow, and he was using it for carpentry and stuff. So it's kind of cool. It brings back some cool memories. This is why we all do these cars. They always, you know, bring back some great memories of everybody's youth and childhood. And stay tuned to the next video.